Yeah, Tommy Sutherland's 11 years old. He's so attentive in class, repeating what he's told. For a boy his age, he looks ready to fly. He also happens to dress just like Bill Nye. He enjoys learning about all the planets and such, though he'd rather be outside, experimenting much. There he could reflect on the theories they presented and ponder dark matter, alone and tormented. Tommy shines when his teacher calls for an answer, but believes something's amiss, something quite deeper. One night, reading about the curve of the ocean, he came across a rather impossible notion. Such horrible news, most would not survive. Could the earth be flat? Hidden by lies? He dug out his telescope from his pop shop, went to the beach to test the earth's drop. But what would arise as he gazed over the pier? The land and a boat that had just disappeared? Bewildered, he ran the numbers at hand. 8 inches per mile squared, but it did not stand. While alone on the beach, the sound quickened away. A quiet voice spoke deep inside. I created it all with you in mind. Tommy tried to talk, but he just couldn't speak. The years of indoctrination that made him weak. So he dropped to his knees and scrawled up in the sand. I am a new person and a part of your plan. He started a group, two friends and his dog. Together they searched for answers there in the fog. They didn't just shine a light on the academic crimes. They run tests outdoors most of the time. While other kids repeat theories like they won, this gang is about action, not to be outdone. They collect real data under the stars. Planets are lights, close up rather than far. As the sun comes round, it's a perspective thing. The moon's its counter, very near we've gleamed. The family did jest, you're crazy with no cred. These experiments you do, they're all up in your head. Science ignores facts, unable to debate. You are not special, Tommy, you came from an ape. You are not worthy of this random round ball. Haven't you heard? Homie, we discovered it all. His anger echoing through the learned halls. As Tommy backed slowly against the wall, the teacher before him was now a zombie slave. As Darwin called out from beyond the grave, he spoke from his coffin, making ghoulish demands. Through the cracking walls reached Neanderthal hands. The school fell away, it began to implode and creak. His mind sorta knew as he began to speak. Every line that had crept into the reams now was decoded, inspired by dreams. To escape the madness, he had reached for the door. Eyes open, floating over linoleum floors. Snow drifting down, hitting his hot face. Zombie teachers, they clung to their place. His voice was soft as he careened and quoted from a powerful internet meme. You sit on a throne of lies.